Hi, my name is Chris Elias, and with this video I will show you what a static pressure test is, how it works, what do you need in order to perform a static pressure test, and of course, what is the right way to perform a static pressure test. Hi, if you're new to my channel, my name is Chris Elias and I'm the owner of Public Detection LLC. If you enjoy this content, please like it and share it with your friends. It really helps me a lot and it motivates me to create more valuable content. Now, let's see what a static pressure test is. A static pressure test is a test that can help you determine if you have a leak in your pipelines. It is a test that anyone can perform without a particular skill, although you will need a few tools and some basic knowledge of how pipelines are connected. But how it works? Let's see how it works. As its name says, static, this test needs no external pressure. By closing all the ends of the testing line except one, you allow the water to travel towards the leak, if any, of course. By testing the line that you suspect the leak, you will observe the dye moving into the pipe. This way you have verified that you have a leak. Note that this test is just to verify the leakage and not the location of the leak. To identify the exact location of an underground leak, you need to contact a leak detector specialist. If you would like to see how we manage to find underground leaks, check out our video on how to find underground water leaks. I promise you to find it pretty interesting. We have found leaks with sound devices, with the hydrogen test, and it's pretty cool. Now, let's see what do you need in order to perform a static pressure test. For a static pressure, you will need rubber or threaded plugs, an open plug or an open cone, and a dye test kit. You can find other products links in the description. But how many plugs do you need? That depends on the number of outlets that you have to test. You need as many plugs as many of the outlets are in the line that you are testing. All of them would be closed except one that would be an open plug or an open cone. If a return line that we suspect the leak has three outlets, you will need two closed plugs and one open one. Imagine a fork, one end from one side and multiple ends at the other side. By closing all the ends except one, you are transferring the internal pressure from the leak to the open end. That is going to be your open plug or open cone. Leak, instead of pulling water from three openings, it pulls harder from one opening. That will help you to observe the dye movement. Now, let's see what is the right way to static pressure test. It is important prior to your test to make sure that you know how many outlets and how many lines you have. Let me show you an example that might clarify some questions that you might have. If you have two return lines as the spy equipment and 12 outlets into the heat tap, then you have to find which outlets are connected together with every pipeline. A simple way to figure out is to run the spy equipment and use the diverter valve to close one of the lines and observe which outlets are adding water into the hot tap and which outlets are not having any pressure. The outlets that are not having any pressure are all connected with the line that you close manually, and those that are pouring water into the spy are connected with the second line. If you still have questions about the lines and outlets, don't worry about it. Leave your question in the comment section and I'll make sure to help you with this challenge. Before you perform a static pressure, you will need to shut off the pool and or spa equipment. You need to make sure that there is no water movement into the pool or spa, or both, and that the water level is at the proper operational level, halfway through the skimmer box. In this example, this hydrant has 8 return jets and all of them are sharing a single line. That means only one pipe is connected with a heater or filter, and this line splits into 8 outlets inside the spout. So for this case, I will use 7 closed plugs and 1 open one that will dye test. When you dial test, try to run in small amounts of dye with as minimum water movement and screw dye as close to the opening as possible. If there is a leak in the line, you will be able to observe the dye traveling into the line. If there is no leak, you will observe no movement and the dye will slowly spread and dissolve into the water. Although that doesn't mean that you have 100% no leak in this line. I know this might confuse you, but you need to consider two other factors in order to conclude there is no leak in the line. The first factor is the pressure leak. If there is a small crack that doesn't leak when the pump is not operating or leaks so slow that it's difficult to observe the water loss with the equipment turned off, that means that you will observe the drop only when the equipment is running. The pipe will leak only when it's under pressure. For this reason, we call it a pressure leak. The second factor is the leak might be located over the water level. If there is a leak that the equipment side and the leak located higher than the pool or spa water level, there will be no water movement. As a result, you will observe no dye movement. As the first factor, the line will lose water when the pump is running. In both scenarios, you need to pressure test the lines in order to properly determine if the line has a leak or holds the pressure. Static pressure test will work for leaks that are constant and will lose water regardless of the operation of the equipment and as long as the leak is below the water level. If you have any questions about the static pressure test, please feel free to leave it in the comment section and I'm always happy to help you with any pool challenge. Also, if you would like to learn how to properly pressure test a pool plumbing lines, you definitely have to check out our video on how to pressure test swimming pools and spa plumbing lines like a pro step by step. And if you enjoy my content, I would like to inform you that likes and shares motivates me to create more valuable content and greatly appreciate it. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe and take care.